Hold on, y'all. I just want to listen to this part. That girl bad. Hey, yeah. Yo, what's up, world? It's your boy, Damian, BlackOpps Entertainment, BlackOpps-TV. We're coming to you live, yes, from Crush Studios. We are up in the building, and happy Friday, okay? This is a Friday, and it's not bad. Not bad. The weather's great in the Carolinas. I don't know where you guys are, but in the Carolinas, the weather's pretty good, so, you know, we're really happy about that. First and foremost, I want to say, make sure, because I always have to say this, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notification button so that you know when we drop another podcast, a video blog, okay? All right. And also, you guys could follow us. Let me make sure I do my little due diligence here. You can follow us on social media. You can follow us on Facebook at Black Ops Entertainment, on IG under Black Ops Entertainment, and of course on Twitter, just Black Ops, BlackOpps, Black Ops, okay? And also, you know, you guys know you can always go to the website, www.blackops.com, because that's where we post mostly everything, okay? It's good to be here. Good to talk to you guys again. I had an interesting conversation. I've known this cat for a minute now. Man, it's been a while. I can't even say how long. It had to be over 15 years, I think. Oh, about 15, maybe a little bit more. But anyway, it's my boy, Omar McCallop. Omar, he is the manager of the National Youth Football Organization, founder of Youth Universities, a licensed real estate broker. The dude's doing it all. He's in the movies, TV production, you name it, in the entertainment business. Oh, the Carolina Music Awards. He's all involved in that. I don't know if you guys know all that, but I know all that. So now that I know, you will know. Okay, I'm gonna make sure you guys. We had a chance to interview Omar, so he'll be coming up later in the show. So I think that's pretty cool. It lets you know that there are people working behind the scenes who are out there trying to make things happen for us so we can have some kind of entertainment. And the whole goal of this particular series is to bring you some of these promoters and producers and let you guys know there are people out there working on your behalf to make sure you have some entertainment options out there. Just got to be safe when you do it, peoples. Okay? All right. So, but one of the things we want to make sure you guys are aware of, you know, we have a upcoming concert coming. Cat Williams will be live at PNC Arena on September the 17th. You guys, if you don't have tickets, make sure you get your tickets. Make sure you wear your mask. Because like I said before, these venues are not playing. The Delta variant and whatever this new variant is, it's not playing. And these venues are not playing either. They want to make sure you guys come with your mask on, come vaccinated or proof that you know, of a negative COVID test. So make sure you guys do what you need to do. This thing's getting a little bit out of hand, but I think we have the wherewithal to do what we need to do to fight this thing so we can stay open and enjoy some semblance of a social life, okay? Can't stress that enough. But also, in September, we have, on September the 25th, live at Coca Booth Amphitheater in Cary, it will be the Temptations Review featuring Nate Evans. Yep, so that's coming on the September 25th. You guys be sure, hey, you could go to blackops.com, you know, and click on and get your tickets, all right? It's an outdoor event, so, you know, the last time I think they had the Jeffrey Osborne concert out there, and that was really, really nice. It was really nice. So you guys be sure to check that out, okay? And of course, my guy, October 3rd at DPAC, Charlie Wilson will be in the building. So I'm really, really looking forward to that concert as well. And like I said, this is what we do, y'all. In case those of you who are new, who may not know, this is what we do. We want to make sure you guys know where all the hottest concerts are, the parties, plays, trips, comedy shows. BlackOpps.com. That's all you gotta do. Go to www.blackops.com and you learn a little bit more about what's going on here in the Triangle area and beyond. Okay. And we're gonna have some behind the scenes commentary on some of these movers and shakers in the entertainment industry, and give you guys some information about how they're putting all this stuff together and how they're really trying to keep these venues open and keep these events going so you guys could get out there and enjoy it. All right. So keep that in mind. We did the Black Ops free ticket giveaway, our Summer Madness free ticket giveaway. We did it for Stomp, which was over at DPAC, and also we did it for Cat Williams. Shout out to all the winners. You can check the winners' names out there on BlackOpps.com. We appreciate you guys supporting us and checking out our website. If you want to register for the next one, go to BlackOpps.com. Click on Summer Madness and make sure you hit registration. Make sure you register with us so next time we have one, you'll be in the running. All right? It's that simple. It's just that simple. Can't get any easier than that. And also, I want to shout out to all my promoters, all these producers, people who are producing the these concerts at DPAC and at PNC Arena, and how they're working with us to make sure we could get some free tickets out there for some of you guys. I know things are kind of tight right now, but, you know, we try to get some free tickets out there for you guys so you can enjoy some of these events, all right? So keep supporting us, and we'll keep supporting you as well, all right? I really want to make sure you guys hear my man Omar. Like I said, I've been knowing Omar since I really started Black Ops Entertainment. We did some stuff together way, way, way back in the day. Man, he reminded me of some stuff that I forgot all about. We were doing concerts and promotions in Virginia for the Fridays at Sunset. Dynasty 5 when they were doing their thing. I mean, it was just a whole lot of information. Carolina Music Festival, I remember that too. But yeah, we were all over this area, and we want you guys to be aware of everything that we do. So, you know, like I said, go to BlackOpps.com. And Omar, he's had a front seat on all this stuff. I had a front seat to all the stuff that, all the great things that he's been doing. He's had a front seat to the whole Black Ops journey that morphed into Crush Model Magazine. You can see them behind me. Hey, ladies. But anyway, that's a segue. We'll talk about Crush later. But so without further ado, I'm going to let you guys listen to my man Omar. If you have any questions, be sure to hit me up regarding anything that he's doing. Like I said, he's the executive producer for a new movie called Avenge, right here. Yeah, you see it right there. And one of the best things about this movie is that it's being shot here in the Triangle area in North Carolina. And they were looking for local actors and actresses. So, I mean, this is going to be a homegrown kind of event. I think he said the opening day, I think they're going to release it in December. So you guys, of course, you know, Black Ops Entertainment will be there. But yeah, without further ado, let me let you talk to my man, Omar McCallop. Take it
away. All right.
Omar.
So ladies and gentlemen, just want to introduce you to a guy I've been knowing for a while. Mr. Omar McCallop. He got his fingers in everything. He's been all over the place. He's a, what I call a media mogul, because he got his fingers in everything, media-wise. Concerts, promotions, the recording industry, the movie industry, the TV industry, award industry. I could go on and on, but I'm not going to do that because we got the man here. We'll let him talk about it. Go ahead and introduce yourself, Omar.
What's going on, man? First, I want to say appreciate you for bringing me on your show. I'm certainly an honor to be able to chat with you or anytime I get the opportunity to. My name is Omar McCallop. My expertise or my degrees or whatever are in marketing, branding, business development. Over the years, my company or companies are in two sections. One is the where we produce events, TV shows, films, award shows, various different content type endeavors of our own creation. If we think up something or we feel like there's a great opportunity or we feel like the market is missing something, then we'll just go and do it. That's how the Carolina Music Awards came about. That's how the Georgia Music Awards came about. That's how the films that I'm working on, the animation that we're working on, that's how Galaxy Studios came about, et cetera, et cetera. The other half of or company or companies is a consulting company where we help other people get their projects or their dreams or aspirations off the ground. So it's a consulting firm, whether it be people, actors, actresses, ran campaigns for political officials, product marketing and branding, artists, singers, actresses. You know, we take pride in taking a person or a product from point A to point Z as to wherever they want to be in their career. So we enjoy, not only do we focus on bringing our own projects to life, but we also help a lot of other people get to where they want to go in the entertainment and in non-entertainment industry as well. Like I used to be, Jack Daniels was a client of mine for years. So that's kind of what we do as a whole. And you mentioned that we have our hands in a lot of different things. And I've had people tell me in the past, like, hey, you guys do too much. But, you know, from our perspective, everything to some degree is marketing and branding. No matter what you do, especially in today's world, everything is marketing and branding. Everything is business development. So for us, there isn't a space that we can't go in just because our expertise is marketing and branding and production. So if there is something outside of that we don't do, it's certainly easy to hire somebody or bring someone on board. Quick example, we're going to do what's called court football. It's a quarterback challenge, to where you have all these quarterbacks from different age groups come to an event, and then you have a winner, and you have all these different tests, and you try to help them get exposure, get college scholarships. Well, even though I coach football, I'm a defensive guy. Obviously, never played quarterback. So we'll hire an expert that's in quarterback to handle that side of it, and then handle that side of it while we plan and market and brand and promote the whole event. So while I'm not a quarterback expert, doing an event like that still has to do with marketing, brand, and business development. And so we hired the people that we need, you know, for their expertise. So it does allow us to be in a lot of places at one time.
Yeah, that's kind of like what Jay-Z did. I mean, he was at Rock Nation, was all about music, and, you know, next you know, they're branching over into sports management and sports entertainment. So, yeah, man, everything's open now. Like you said, everything's marketing. Everything's branding. So you could go into pretty much any field that you want.
There's one thing they will now, man. They leverage their celebrity. They leverage their brand perfectly. Because what sports person wouldn't want to be involved with them? I'm sorry, what was that?
No, it was something you said earlier. I know we talked about, I know a little bit about, you know, what you did early on, you know, as far as being a music producer and television and, you know, movies and, you know, awards. But you said animation. That's one thing I haven't really heard about you doing. So can you kind of expound on that a little bit? What do you mean by animation?
So, you know, I'm a big fan of animation, and it's an amazing space to be in. And it's also an amazing space for, you know, African Americans as well. So a while back, my first stab at animation, you kind of see my shirt, which is someone within my organization drew. But my first stab at animation is really a good story. We put together a show called Down South, and the show was about, it's kind of like Golden Girls, but it was like four black grandmas from the South. So kind of take Golden Girls, but we had these four grandmas, and they were not your average grandmas. They, you know, dip snuff and, you know, curse and go to church the next day. So we had this thing called Down South. We did a short reel for it. And I actually had a buddy of mine that had a relationship with Viacom and MTV, who was doing a lot of animation at the time. And he got us a one-on-one up at MTV and Viacom in New York, and which was really cool because I never pitched something like that to a major entity. it turned us down, but we learned a valuable lesson. So that was a long time ago. It was like 10 years ago, maybe. And because mm-hmm. animation was so expensive, we were at the wrong place at the wrong time. Because if you notice television trends, back then they kind of stopped animation, and that's when reality TV was really
took over
because reality TV is cheap to shoot. You just get some people that's going to act crazy, put a camera in their face. So a lot we had bad times go like there, and they liked it, but it was bad, like $100,000. Now, you know, there's Upworks and Further and all these other overseas companies that are doing animation a lot cheaper. So, long story short, we got turned down. I love Down South Project. We're about to bring it back out. And then in the meantime, it just so happens a bunch of these guys from Royal House Comics, and we have done a partnership deal with them, and that's all they do. So we have an app coming out that has an app, a comic book, and a web series, all animation. So we partnered with them to handle, again, their marketing, brand business development, and they're handling the, and my other partner, Charlie Koch, is writing the scripts and all the dialogue from Black Astronaut Productions, and we're all partnering together to do not just one animation piece, but we have three animation projects. And also, we're going to bring Down South back, which will be four. And we're actually going to Comic-Con in L.A. At the end of the year.
Okay.
The app is crazy. The app is amazing. It's called Dombe. But it's a full, like, you probably remember Street Fighter?
Yeah.
The video game Street Fighter. So it's based, the comic is based on, it's a real life, if you look at Dombe, they do it now in Africa. It's kind of like UFC in Africa. It's what it is. We adapted a cartoon after it. We adapted a app from it. So yeah, I'm super excited about my first app ever. But it's an app coming off of a cartoon. So able to jump into the tech space a little bit with the app.
Yeah. Is that app?
From the app producers. I got a video of it. It's on my page. I'll tag you to it. You can see the full functionality of the app. So we're just waiting. You have to wait for it to clear Apple, and then you gotta wait for it to clear Android. So we're in that process now. But I'll tag you to the video of the app, and you can see it's pretty much done. It's just like a Street Fighter, but it's all different characters from this African UFC called Dombe, and it's been around 100 years, and they still do it. So it's amazing. He showed me how the projects they had made. I was like, oh man, this is amazing. So. And picking fighters and all kinds of stuff. But yeah, I'll tag you to the video of the progress of the app. We're just really waiting for it to clear Apple and Android, and then we'll decide when we're going to release it. But no later, I would say, than spring of next year.
Spring. Okay. And one of the other things that I know you're involved with, and I kind of reached out to you for some of the people I know who want to be involved. And this movie Avenged that you got going on, your executive producer, you want to expound on Avenged a little bit?
Yeah, so it's a guy. I used to have a studio in downtown Raleigh, and this guy, I don't know his real name, I just called him Bo, that was his rap name. So he was a rapper, but he also was a filmmaker. He wanted to be in the film, he did comedy, he did so many other things. And I said, Bo, a million people are rapping right now. Let's take a look at some of your other talents. So we just kind of communicated and talked. The studio, we closed it because of COVID. But we just, he's a great writer. He's a filmmaker. His editing skills, he has a really great eye. So he's like, hey, I want this thing called Avenged. And he let me read it, and I was like, yo, this is really good. So we started producing and filming and casting, and just said, hey, let's do this movie. And so then he had a relationship with Jamal Wood. Most people know him from the Notorious movie, the Notorious movie. And then so we connected with him, man. He came up, he read it, he liked it. He came to Raleigh. We shot his scenes probably in a 2-day 2 days straight. We shot all of his scenes so he could get back to LA, because he's back and forth between LA and in Atlanta. And we all just like creatives. Sometimes people think that, you know, creatives in Hollywood have to be, you know, a pain in the butt or jerks, and everybody's not like that. So it was really cool because it was just, you know, God, you know, three guys trying to, you know, make this film that we all like and work together. So shout out to him for being so easy to work with. And that was pretty much it, man. I really am championing film and TV in Raleigh. That's important to me. I want, and the whole state, but I really, really, really want to push film and TV in Raleigh. Not just my stuff, just anybody who's willing to put the time and work in. Like, you know, Bo has put a ton of time and work and money. We both are into this film and just hard work. So, yeah, we're really dedicated. The film is pretty much done. We're casting about, we got about four or five more small roles, extra roles that we're cast. And it worked out so good, we decided to add a little bit more to Jamal's part. So he's coming back. I think October the 7th is the date. He's coming back. We're going to film those last few scenes. And then we're going to have a big wrap party with all the cast and crew. And, you know, just celebrate closing the film out, at least from the filming part. We'll still be, you know, tinkering with the editing. And then we're going to release it Christmas Day. We're not sure if we're going to be Amazon Prime. I got a relationship at Netflix, so we're not sure. But we'll be dedicated to releasing it on Christmas Day, while everybody's in the house with their family and want something to do. So on some platform, we haven't decided for sure yet, but we're going to release it on Christmas Day. And you know what? We're going to jump right into the next film. I'm writing with Charlie this piece called 10 Jobs that I'm excited about. Man, we just want to produce content.
Is that about you?
10 jobs? No, it's not.
It sounds like it.
It could be.
It sounds like you, Omar.
No, it's not. But it's kind of like, it reminds me, as I haven't finished writing it yet, but it kind of reminds me of Natural Born Killers. And see, I'm probably dating myself because most people won't know that movie. I watch a lot of movies. Yeah. So it's good. And it's the people that I have in mind to start it are right here in Raleigh. So right here in the Triangle. So, you know, we want to go out and find, you know, talented, not just talented people, man, but hardworking, dedicated people. You know, like I know, like as the old saying goes, man, good help is hard to find.
You know? Right.
That's why there's a circle of only like a very few of us. Like, you know, you can call me and I can call you and I can call Suleiman. And, you know, those are small circles or Reggie Burrell or now, you know, Official Rally Boy, or just, you know, Pistol. Just there's a group of individuals that, you know, and we want to expand that group. We want to expand that group of people that you can depend on in the market and in the industry, so that if they say it's going to get something's going to get done, or I'm going to be here at this place at that time, you can depend on that, you know. And so, but we are developing that. We are finding those people there. I haven't worked with the lady that you sent us, but I know Boa plans on working with her, and that they had a conversation, so he's really excited about her. You know, just quality people, man. And, you know, do what you say you're going to do to the best of your ability. I mean, that's what we are all about. But yeah, I'm continuing to be excited. I'm doing a horror flick. We would be further along in production on a horror movie. My partner in the horror movie, Charlie, he had some illness in his family, so he's taking care of that right now. But as soon as that's over, he's from Durham. He's from your neck of the woods.
City.
So that's right. So one of the best screenwriters that I know, man, Charlie Cox. He's actually a bass guitar player, and I met him through the Carolina Music Awards.
Really?
So he's another guy that's multi-talented, plays a mean bass guitar, but his writing, his TV and film writing style is tremendous. He's written it just goes on and on. He's written this other movie called Descendant that I love. You know, it's just, it's kind of a sci-fi thriller, so it's a little bit more expensive to produce, so we're going to have to wait till we hit the big to do it, but it's like, I, it's like, like a Marvel universe unto itself, but in a different space. It's amazing. So, yeah, man, we just shout out to Yolanda, man. You know, my relationship over at Netflix. I have a relationship that I'm developing over at BET. And all of this stuff kind of really just, you know, the production in the TV film has been around me for a while. But yeah, a lot of these upper level relationships, man, really had just surfaced so that I could get to a Netflix. I could get to a Viacom, or, you know, Viacom for people may not know that own BET.
BET, MTV.
Yeah, a bunch of networks. So, you know, just to be in a position. So I am just, you know, getting content together. And I say this really quick, too, from the TV film side. I mean, I know a lot of talented people on the TV film side. For all you guys out there who are on that side, you have to complete projects. You can't start a film or start a TV show and don't complete it till 5 years later or 2 years later.
Move your hand. Move your hand. Black in your face.
I know people who started films, started TV shows, and it takes them 2 or 3 years to complete. You know, that's what I love about working with Charlie and Boa and some of our other partners, man. Especially Boa. Boa, like, he'll film every day. He'll film and edit every day. So he's ready to rock and roll right now, and that's how I like to work. It's kind of like, and I don't mean that you quit your job or nothing like that if you have one, but, you know, it has to be a priority. Just like, you know, my son plays ball. That has to be outside of school. It has to be a priority. So if you really want to, you know, music, you know, I got music clients, or I had music clients where music, being an artist, wasn't a priority. I wouldn't talk to them about music or about what we're trying to do. A whole week would go by, or 2 weeks would go by, and we wouldn't have a conversation. About what's next. So I'm like, hey, you must don't really want to do this, because it's like it's, you know, it's third or fourth or fifth in your life, you know, now if somebody's sick or something like that, obviously, but, you know, I don't think people understand how aggressive people who want to do what you want to do, they don't understand how aggressive the people who really want to do it are. Because you're competing with every other actor out there, every other actress out there, every other
studio company.
You're in competition. You gotta be willing to go hard. So I think sometimes that is overlooked, and you say, hey, well, I'm not successful. I'm talented. It's talent and hard work.
You gotta push. So you mentioned music, and that took me back to the, I know we mentioned it a little bit, the Carolina Music Awards. So you're still slated to try to do that in 2022?
Yeah, we took the first pandemic year off, I guess, which was 2020. They called me a ton of times for 2021 because they're obviously venues and things like that are losing money. So they're like, hey, you gonna do the awards? And I'm like, nah, it's still too up and down. And you've been to the awards, you're like, see it like right beside somebody at the awards show. And it's usually packed. So it's not, and we're in this building for, man, what time did we start? We started like maybe 7 or 8 or something. We're there till 10.
Yeah.
So you're talking about 2 or 3 hours of people being like right beside each other. People are cheering. It's just not a conducive environment when there's so many things that we don't know, or so many things up in the air about COVID. So I just personally didn't feel comfortable trying to do it this year. But we're locked in. We have a date. We added gospel to the Carolina Music, gospel and Christian music to the Carolina Music Awards this year. Mm-hmm. We added a whole separate Carolina Music Festival, that's separate and apart from the awards. And the primary venues that are going to be the Lincoln Theater and the Poorhouse, and depending on how big it is, we may have a third venue, but we're already locked into the Lincoln Theater and the Poorhouse for the Carolina Music Festival, which is going to be separate day from the Carolina Music Awards. So we're expanding, you know, we're expanding everything because we got more time to prepare. We got almost a whole year to prepare for it. So, I mean, and it's our 15th year. So I think that, man, it's going to be, without question, the biggest year for the award.
Okay. Well, I'm going to put my dibs in now. I want to be there at the Carolina Music Awards. So I have BlackOpps-TV there. We can interview and do backstage the whole nine. Also, I want to be there for that rap.
You said it froze on the word rap. You want to be there for that rap.
The rap party for Avenge.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man. Definitely. Come through.
You're more than welcome. So we put it out today. We just locked in Jamal. We got his schedule because the crazy thing is, man, everything is trending upwards. He just locked in two really, really big movies that signed the contract for and that not even public yet. But even with that, he still believes in what we're doing because he could have just blown us off like, hey, you know, I got two big features. I'm not doing, you know, indie movie or what have you. He could have easily blew us off. But no, he's like, no, I like what you guys are doing. I like the concept because there's multiple movies that go with Avenge. It's really a prequel to the further story, which is Bad Preacher. So there's like three movies in the whole saga, and this is just one of them. So. But yeah, he has some really, really big. Make sure you follow him on Instagram, Jamal Gravy Willard. But yeah, so we locked him in yesterday, so we were able to get the dates locked in. And now we're just deciding what venues we're going to have the rap party.
Okay. So, but everything you got going on, I mean, like music, television, movies, animation, plays, skits, everything else. There may be somebody who's out there who really could use your expertise, use your connections, and may just want your opinion on what they're trying to do, or they're trying to break into any one of those industries that you're, you know, deeply embedded in. How can they get in touch with Omar McCallop?
That's a trick question. I think the best way to do it right now is probably Instagram. I certainly check my Instagram messages every day. The Real Super O is my Instagram. I don't necessarily. I'm there more than I am on email, and I rarely do phone calls because it just sucks up so much time. But yeah, if it's a quick question or something, you know, it really just depends on how sincere a person is and how hardworking they are. You know, but certainly if you want to, you know, drop me a message or you got a question about something, the best way to do it for the quickest response is my Instagram, because I'm on it all the time, because that's kind of my break. It's my source of entertainment.
Instagram.
So yes, because since my friends and family say I never turn off what they say. Like, yeah, you got to figure out how you turn off. How do you take a break? How do you rest your brain? Yeah, that's true, but I enjoy what I do. It's not really like work. So for me, you know, I don't feel like there's a reason to turn off, but you know, I guess everybody needs a break. So that's kind of, I can flip through that and laugh at some stuff and do some work at the same time. So that's where I'm at. So if somebody hits me and asks me a question, and then I have a consulting firm. So I have a whole process of going from a general question to say, okay, cool. You really want, you know, more of my expertise and relationships and connections and things like that. But yeah, the Real Super O is my Instagram. You can send me, some people have their Instagrams locked down to where they can't accept messages. I don't. So yeah, DM me there and then, you know, we'll figure it out.
All right, man. Well, like I said, man, I appreciate your time because you don't seem like you have enough of it. So I appreciate any time you can dedicate to Black Ops, man. I know I've been at it. I don't know how long I've been at it with Black Ops. Had to be at least between, 15 years? Maybe 20. But you was going, even before I met you, you were already, you know, doing your thing. So, yeah, we've been
when I was in college is when I started doing concerts and stuff and parties. Mm-hmm. I remember when the Biggie Tour was at the Ding Dong, and I was at Carolina in school. When the Biggie Tour was at the Dean Dome, and I carried speakers in there. And that's another thing. I think a lot of times people you know, they come and we have conversations and they want to start at the top. But like I said, I remember carrying speakers. I had a concert promoter that was a mentor of mine and kind of showed me the ropes. I didn't get paid. I just was around. I was around to learn and soak up knowledge and just, you know, I had a lot of fun because we were in clubs. I remember he brought Left Eye to Plum Crazy and he was like, you're in charge of this event. And so many things went wrong with that event. I think he made a little bit of money, but so many things went wrong with the event from my perspective. He was like, no, you did a good job. You know, you didn't have this resource. You didn't have this resource. But I was upset. I remember being upset. I was like, yo, this is horrible. But I learned a lot. I mean, that's what I think people who are aspiring and want to get involved, I just think you got to be willing to step back and learn where a lot of people just jump in like, oh, I already know. So.
Yeah, and put in the work.
Yeah,
definitely. Put in the work. Yeah, they think we just got here. We've been at this for years.
Yep.
All right, my brother. Well, like I said, I appreciate your time, man. It's good talking to you, and I'm pretty sure we're going to link up soon with some other projects. And my boy is still, he may still want to holler at you about that project he was trying to do. So he's still trying to work that agent thing out. But I'll keep you posted on that. All right.
Okay, and I will let you know once we lock in the locations for the rap party. I'll let you know.
All right, man. Sounds like a plan. All right, Omar.
All right, man. Thank you.
I'll see you later, man. All right.
Bye bye.
Okay. So yeah, we're back. I hope you guys enjoyed that interview with Omar. My man got a lot of stuff going on. I thought I had a lot of stuff going on. This dude he got a lot of stuff going, a lot of positive things going on, and he still make time for the kids. Got to make time for the kids, y'all. Got to make time for the kids. But that's all we have for right now. You guys stay safe and look out for each other, and we'll see you on the next edition of Black Ops Entertainment and Black Ops TV. Black Ops Entertainment, taking urban entertainment to a whole new level. Peace.